tough place to go. All right, welcome to the serving table training for French toast. So there's some training guidelines that I have here. Okay, we'll go over them. First one, stay mentally and physically present. Second one, no cell phones. No cell phone disruptions. I can't take your cell phones. Third, participate by sharing stories, asking questions, or respectfully contributing. There will be some prompts during the training. Number four, let everyone participate. Be patient while others are talking and let them have their time. Listen with an open mind. Think before speaking. Attack the problem or challenge the idea, and not the person. Be professional and use appropriate language, free of bias, give honest feedback, and have fun. Some of this is going to be like a game of networks. It's going to be great. Session objectives. At the end of the training, all trainees will demonstrate sanitation standard operating procedures, utensils, and cookware. Properly cleaned and stored after use and held to a degree of cleanliness while being used. Ingredients will be stored properly and there will be no cross-contamination of any ingredients. Employees will demonstrate proper hand washing procedure and communicate understanding of when to wash hands. Number two, at the end of the training, all trainees will dress and act in a professional manner as per dress code expectations and code of conduct. Uniforms will be neat and orderly. Non-slip shoes, serving gloves, and hairnets will be worn while serving food or working in the kitchen. Hair will be kept up and nails will be kept short. At the end of the training, all trainees will be able to successfully demonstrate appropriate behavior when dealing with customers. Employees will engage in small talk, make non-aggressive eye contact, and smile. Employees will be able to address customer grievance or difficult customers professionally. At the end of the training, all trainees will be able to successfully demonstrate communication and conflict resolution skills with other trainees. At the end of the training, all trainees will be able to fill in for other positions on the serving table. So, we'll go over introductions. Then there's three topics, parents, relations with others, and cleanliness. Introductions! I'm Lucas Bear.
Nice to meet you, Lucas Bear.
So I've had 25 years of experience in the food industry. You guys know probably I came from Cavendish. Before that, I worked in a restaurant here in town, the Depot. Oh. Pretty classic joint. Right now, I'm a Valley City University student majoring in business process integration management and minoring in communication. Okay, company's Last Boy Catering. It was founded by Zarissa von Lipstand. Okay, Zarissa was raised in a Pastafarian orphanage in Djibouti. She specializes in catering charity events. The experience in the orphanage instilled her sense of purpose. What you do makes a difference, and you have to decide what kind of difference you want to make. Jake Goodall. Bread and butter. Employees make or break the company. Employees influence the type of service offered. Employees influence how a service is delivered. You are the most influential part of the company. What you do and how you do it makes a difference. Topic one, appearance. What is appearance? What is appearance? Anybody got anything?
How you see someone.
How you see someone or maybe a restaurant. So, appearance is defined as the way that someone or something looks, the act of performing or participating in a public event. That's the official definition. Appearance influences how others perceive us and how we perceive ourselves. That's interesting, right? How we perceive ourselves. Appearance is presentation. Context and memory play powerful roles in all the truly great meals in one's life. That's what we're doing. Presentation includes the food, the staff, and the equipment. Customers perceive more value in food when it is made right before their eyes. Examples of presentation. That one? Anybody? Anybody have one? Well, this is kind of the same question. So, like, maybe...
Your shoes. Your shoes, the way you dress.
Oh, yeah, but, like, in restaurants. Any examples of presentation in restaurants?
The little stuff on the plate to garnish it.
Yep.
Yeah.
That is appearance. Presentation. How about, like, when you go into, like, Olive Garden? And there's, you know, they have like the Italian theme.
Oh, the cheese grinder.
Yeah, and everything has the.
Tell me when.
Yep.
Yeah.
Or,
don't stop now.
Like Texas Roadhouse. You go into Texas Roadhouse and they.
The peanuts all over the
floor. They do line dancing.
Boop scoop boogie, yeah. All good examples of presentation in restaurants.
Yeah.
Personal presentation.
The chef hat. The chef's hat will prevent hair from falling into the food, will absorb sweat from your brow, and identify you as a professional. If your hair is long, it must be kept up in a hairnet and tucked under the chef's hat. If your hair goes below the neck, a hairnet is required. For male students, you have to be clean-shaven. The chef coat is made out of tough fabrics that protect you from heat, spills, and the stove and grill in front of you. Please wear a plain white shirt under the chef coat. Make sure the buttons are done up all the way to the top. Roll the sleeves once and do not wipe your hands on your coat, apron, or pants. The Canada logo must be properly displayed and clean on the uniform at all times. The apron acts as a sanitary barrier between you and the food. The apron should be folded once, tied in the front, and folded again. The square apron should come down below the knees, and you should be removing the apron before you leave the lab. The side towel is used to remove pots and pans from either the oven or the stove. The towel must remain dry. The pants consist of a dark checkered material to help maintain a clean and professional appearance. The pants should be properly fitted and in good condition, not frayed, ripped, or low-hanging. Hem the leg to the appropriate length and do not have anything hanging from the pockets. Jewelry is banned in the kitchen. That includes any visible body piercings. Also, please keep your fingernails short and clean. Do not wear any fake nails or nail polish. You'll be standing on your feet for an extended period of time and may have to walk on wet floors. You are required to wear a comfortable pair of black non-slip leather shoes. Wear black socks and keep shoes polished and tied. Do not wear open toe, open heel, or running shoes. Everything in this video is up to Canada College Sanitation Code. We ask everyone who enters the kitchen to please abide by these guidelines. I hope you have a good year in your program and good luck.
That was great. Okay, topic two, relations with others. How does presentation and appearance apply to customer relations? Well, I do have a story. It was about... presentation, and it was customer relations as well. One time I went to Subway, right, and I ordered a sandwich, as one would do, and the woman who made my sandwich, her apron was just nasty, right? So she's making my sandwich, and she brings it over, and what do you want on your sandwich, you know, so I tell her. And she leans over
Whoa.
Right on my sandwich, right? So that kind of wraps up everything, you know, we've been talking about so far.
Yeah.
So that's an example. Anybody have any other horror stories? Because I'd love to hear.
Mine, that's probably the same stuff what you're talking about.
Yeah.
But her
forest was literally sitting on top of my sandwich.
Extra meat.
Extra meat.
Thank you, Melissa. Okay. How does presentation of variance apply to customer relations? How does being presentable to customers relate to us and our job roles? One, looking nice, clean, and professional. Two, being relatable, telling quick, easy jokes when appropriate, for example. Three, being polite, smiling, saying thank you, making eye contact. Four, being respectful, addressing people as sir or ma'am. Five, being helpful, give suggestions as to what you like as far as the toppings, for example. Six, being considerate, if people need more time, don't rush them, be patient with them. Seven, be attentive, compliment something about a customer's appearance. You don't have to address every customer in every way, but you should address enough of them that it is noticed by those around. In this way, every customer can see you being a good representative of the company through the interaction with just a few customers. Trick people. Surface acting. Assume the worst about everybody, but don't let this poison outlook affect your job performance. Let it all roll off the bat, ignore it. Be amused by what you see and suspect. Just because someone you work with is a miserable, treacherous, self-serving, capricious, and corrupt, you guys, shouldn't prevent you from enjoying their company, working with them, or finding them entertaining. Anthony Bourdain. Love Anthony Bourdain. Ways to mitigate the emotional burden caused by surface acting. Focus on the positive aspects of people. Being aware of and confident that you are an excellent host helps mitigate the emotional burden of surface acting. You don't have to like people. You are there to make sure people have a good time, and surface acting facilitates that. You guys all know what surface acting is? It's like superficial, you know, being polite, all that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people, you know, like if you take leadership courses, people will talk about like how leaders manipulate people and things like that. But you can't look at it like manipulation, because like a host, if you go to a party and a good host, it's very manipulative, right? Because that host wants you to have a good time and, you know, tries to trick you having a good time. Three, if you notice a coworker struggling with a customer, intervene on their behalf. Take a break. Five, if a customer has a problem, make it your problem. Look for ways it can be fixed. Helping others helps you feel good about yourself. Now, number three says, intervene on a coworker's behalf. And this one says, make it your problem. That doesn't mean go to blows. Zach. Okay, exercise discussion. All the techniques, I'm sorry, we gotta back up. Okay, I've got an exercise, and that's what we were supposed to discuss. So I need at least two volunteers. Anybody? Anybody wanna
are we
volunteer?
Doing first of all?
What?
Can I know what we're doing first?
Yeah, it's just like a role playing thing.
Oh,
so I need like a good customer, bad customer.
I think Zach can do it.
Yes.
Yeah?
I think Zach and Melissa should do
yeah.
it.
Yes.
Yeah, I actually
yes.
was thinking that too.
Yeah,
well,
that's
yeah,
the whole point.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
Bad customer, good server.
Oh, he's a good.
But, you know, if somebody's patience gets pushed, it's kind of cross the line in the bad server, that's okay, we'll talk about it.
Oh.
Alright, so come on.
Do you have to stay appropriate?
Yes.
Well, maybe rated R. I think the Film Association says that's one F-bomb. Yeah?
All right.
Are you going to be the nice one?
I'm always the nice one. What am I doing?
Are you going to like set the scene here?
Yeah, okay. I think Subway. It's Subway. It's Subway.
E-Fresh.
You are the bad customer. E-Fresh.
Bad customer.
Yep. Do you not want to be the bad customer? Do you want to be the server?
Oh, I don't know.
Do you want to put your boobs in your sandwich?
Oh, yeah.
Yep. All right.
Well, that'd be a bad server.
How about this? You guys just go with whatever. And if you're a bad customer, then bad server. I think Melissa should be the server.
Yeah.
So you want me to be a bad customer?
Yeah, nice one.
Okay. I don't like this piece of paper you sold me. It sucks.
This is really hard for
make
can
it
I get you a new piece of paper?
I don't think that's going to make up for it. That's so bad.
You crinkled it. You made it bad.
Why are you petting the paper?
Can I get you a different kind of paper?
Yes. Okay.
Glitter.
Of course.
Scented.
Scented.
You never know. You never know what you're into.
Why would I want scented toilet paper?
I didn't know you wanted toilet paper. You didn't specify what you wanted.
I don't like that one either. It touched the ground.
You can just leave the store then.
Okay, good. Alright, so.
A visitor date.
What could be so fun to make that go better?
I concur.
Yeah? I mean, she offered to get him a new sandwich after a little bit of old humming, but, you know. Overall, it was pretty good. Maybe she could have went to a... Yeah, or a manager or something, you know. Good. Okay, all the techniques and considerations used in positive customer interactions can also be used in all our interactions with coworkers. We are all in this together, delivering a quality product for a good cause. It is important to support each other, whether that means covering each other's stations or just showing up with a positive attitude. It's okay to disagree, but not okay to disrespect. When we agree to disagree, we honor the relationship above trying to change the person. Some people cannot be changed. Plantation! Ethan and Jake, clean it up. You guys. Right? Knowing is not enough, we must apply. Willing is not enough, we must do. Wuhan, Wuking, on course. Sanitation should be looked at as a whole process from beginning to end. Modern equipment is designed with this consideration, and much of the equipment we use is viewed from a sanitary standpoint, as we learned when discussing our uniforms. Sanitation starts. Sanitation, in addition to the other food safety processes we undertake, is dictated in part by the U.S. Food Code, a series of preventive and overlapping safeguards designed to minimize foodborne illness, promote fair dealings with consumers, and promote fair dealings with government entities. It is the responsibility of all the staff to ensure that sanitation standards are met. Hand washing. It is very important to wash hands to prevent foodborne illness and cross-contamination. Wash hands after directly handling ingredients, using bathroom facilities, treating a wound, blowing your nose, coughing or sneezing, or after you handle garbage. If your hands are contaminated in any way, you need to wash them. How do I wash my hands? There's another video. Yeah, you can contribute.